Happy November 1st, 2024. When you see this video, it'll already be November. It'll already be a few days in, but it is the first day of November right now making this video, which is crazy. But it's definitely a great time to be reselling. Anytime's a great time to be reselling, but this is fourth quarter. This should be the best time of the year from now, essentially, until, into the new year. So definitely list everything that you have. Don't leave anything sitting around. Don't leave anything in your eBay drafts. Have it all go live, and price your right items right, and you should be seeing a lot of sales. So I wanted to share with you, I'm down here in my bookstore, and I wanted to share with you a couple sales that I had in the last 24 hours. So it's November 1st. It is Friday. And these videos are being made obviously the week before. I'm out of town next week when you're seeing this. So so these videos will be from the previous week. But anyway, these are sales that I had on the in the last 24 hours. I also had an eBay lot, a VHS tape lot that sold on eBay for, I think it was like 25 to 30 bucks. I'm not remembering at the moment, but I'll share it with you if I remember to record it. But this is what sold on Amazon, these three here, and then those three sold on eBay. Now all three of these were donations or pickups here at the bottom. Two books and one audiobook. That's right, audiobook, a CD compact disc audiobook. They still sell really well. Certain titles that are hard to find, either out of print, in demand, etc. People still do listen to CD audiobooks in their car, at home, whatever it may be. This is David Sedaris box set. I think it has, I don't know. Oh, it's got all of these books in there. So if you're familiar with David Sedaris, he's a comedic nonfiction writer, writes a lot about, the Barrel Fever is fiction, but most of it's nonfiction, writes a lot about sort of satire and about his life and his observations of life. Really funny if you haven't listened to him. This one actually sold for $42.35. That was a pickup back in August. So that was a really nice sale. So be on the lookout for this for sure. Bolo, I guess. I mean, it's probably not unlikely you're going to come across it, but you never know. You never know. Maybe sitting on the shelf there in the thrift store, or you might see it at an estate sale, or you might see it at a garage sale, or a library book sale, and you might think, oh, David Sedaris box set, whatever. But this one, it did sit since August, but selling for 42 bucks. Really nice sale, guys. Always look at the audiobooks for sure. If you're doing only Amazon or doing Amazon and eBay, this one happened to sell on Amazon. I've sold a lot of box sets, audio book sets, CD sets on Amazon and on eBay, both. This one here is from the same pickup as this donation back in August. It is the Archive Documents of Contemporary Art. And this one sold for $28.35. I don't know. It's one of those books that if I saw when I saw the cover, I would think to look it up. It's a more scholarly book, etc. And it came from a local college that was getting rid of books. Most of the books that I picked up there, I mean, I was surprised that there was an audiobook there, but most of them were from professors that had left and either retired or were going to another college and just left behind all the books they had in their offices. So 28 bucks, 42 bucks, those were nice sales. And then this one is, I got recently, Lobbying for Zionism on Both Sides of the Atlantic. I think it's a newer book. This one sold for $15.88. Thing about this one is I listed it recently, and then just yesterday I actually repriced it myself. This is from 2024, so this is a very recent book. I just repriced it yesterday, and I dropped the price because, of course, Amazon's full of automatic repricers who reprice every second, and I just happened to grab the sale. I initially had listed it for $22, but I ended up dropping it all the way down to $15.88 to get the sale. And considering that it was a book I didn't pay for, I don't mind. Even if I paid a buck for it, it'd still be worth it. You know, if you sell on Amazon, you know how it is. And essentially, whether you're doing FBA, whether you're doing merchant fulfilled, you have to fight on the price. And oftentimes, people, either, you know, individuals or bigger companies, bookselling companies have repricers in place to be repricing essentially constantly, especially when someone reprices below them. So I tried a repricer, I couldn't figure it out. So I'm back to doing it myself, and I still get sales, as you can see, but obviously, you know, one day I would like to figure out the whole repricing nonsense and have it be done automatically in a way that is effective. But I'm not there yet. So one day I still get Amazon sales, but just not as often as I probably would if I had an automatic repricer. And then I sold these on eBay. Let's see, this book was here from, this was found on one of the shelves here in the store. And this one is Beyond the High Himalayas by William O. Douglas. I don't know what year it's from. It sold for $23.99 plus shipping. Still has the dust jacket. Let's see, 1952. Yeah, 1952. Got some pictures in there as well, some color pictures. Would you think that this one would go for 23 bucks on eBay? And then she listed it for $29.99. Not a bad sale, especially considering this book was just sitting on the shelf here in my store, and it was unlikely it was going to sell. Putting it up on eBay goes to a bigger audience, and it didn't take very long to move that. This one is Josh Ritter, The Animal Years, a CD. I think it's still sealed. Not sure what type of music it is. It sold for $11.33. That came from a donation a while ago, so that's been sitting for a while. And then this one, Grant's Gaelic Hymns. This also was a donation from a couple of years ago. I don't want to open it too much. Oh, it's from 1870. Sold for $24. Free shipping, unfortunately, when I was still doing free shipping. It's a really old Gaelic hymn book. So the kind of, you know, random stuff, not random, but the kind of stuff I sell on eBay. I sold a VHS tape lot. I sold this, you know, older 1952 book, and this one from way back in 1870, and then a sealed CD. And then on Amazon, you know, two books and an audiobook. So it's really kind of represents the different types of items that I sell online and why it's important to have Amazon and eBay in your tool belt as a reseller. And I understand if you're coming from eBay only and you look at Amazon as this monster that you don't think you want to get to know and be friends with and figure out. And if you're coming from Amazon, you kind of look at eBay the same way. I have to take pictures. Doesn't that take forever? I don't get it. That kind of thing. But if you're doing merchant fulfilled on Amazon, eBay is the same. It's just that you have to take pictures. So it takes longer to list. But I recommend if you're going to sell on eBay in the media that you really just go for the higher dollar, 30 and up, you know, minimum 20 and up. But I would say try to creep up a little more. But 20 and up minimum on eBay when you're starting out taking pictures of stuff. Stuff that just won't do as well on Amazon. Like these two books are a perfect example from 1952, from 1870. Those aren't going to do as well on Amazon in general. So it's just good to have both marketplaces and use both marketplaces and know which items make more sense on what. All right, guys, thanks for watching. Happy November. And I'll see you in the next video. Have a good one.